Hey guys, I'm Chef Dean Max. Welcome back to my kitchen. Today we're gonna do Gulf Shrimp Summer Rolls, okay? Summer rolls are super simple. You can do it with your friends and family. Have a fun time with it, make a party of it. It's gonna be great. Stay with me. Click subscribe if you're not doing that already. Give me a thumbs up if you like this video. Ring that bell. I'll send you new things I have coming up. So see you back in a second. Okay guys, so with these summer rolls, we're gonna get these started off really quick. I've got all my ingredients here in front of me. Now, I've got some boiling water. Let me show you what that looks like. So I've got some just boiling salted water, okay? Tastes so good. I put a little celery salt in there as well. I like that flavor with shrimp. I'm gonna take the shrimp like this, these beautiful Gulf shrimp with the shells on. I don't like to take the shells off. I think that it dilutes a lot of their flavor. There's fat underneath those shells that we want. I'm just gonna drop those in like this, and I'm gonna stir them around. And I'm gonna let those cool in, right now in that liquid, okay? And then I'm gonna give you a time on those. Those are U20s, so that means there's 20 shrimp to a pound, okay? You can do any size you want. If you wanna do small shrimp or bigger ones, but we're gonna cut them in half anyway. Now here, I've got some thin rice noodles or bean noodles, and I've got hot boiling water right out of my kettle, right? I soaked those just a touch. Like I pulled them out of the package and soaked them in there for a little bit. And then now I'm pouring all this boiling water on there, okay? And at this point, we're just gonna move it. I gotta do that carefully, right? Because that's boiling water, right? And I'm gonna let that sit in that boiling water and those will cook. Now, if you wanna put those in boiling water and dump them in boiling water, they'll take like a minute to cook and then you can just strain them out. But if you just pour the boiling water on like this and let them sit in there 3 or 4 minutes, 5 minutes, they're gonna be cooked perfectly. So I do it that way. Right now, we're gonna get some of the other stuff ready. So I've got some bean sprouts here. You can see those. If you don't like bean sprouts, you don't have to use them. I've got cucumber, all right? Now with my cucumber, I'm gonna take like an English cucumber. You can use Persian cucumbers. I just don't use a domestic thick one that's got a wax on it because you'd have to peel those. If you have that, go ahead and peel those. So the skin is very waxy, you need to peel them, right? With these, I'm just gonna cut them in half. Now a lot of times I cut the seeds out, but because this particular dish is a very kind of very fresh dish to have, I don't cut the seeds out. And plus it's not marinating for a long time, right? The longer you would marinate, those little seeds in there become watery, but we don't care about that in this. We're just gonna slice these up into strips like this, because these are gonna go into our rolls, okay? And our rolls are gonna be kind of super, kind of chunky and simple to eat. Only thing is I cut them in like kind of these long, thin, slender strips, so they're easy to bite into when we roll these up. So just long, thin strips, straight down like this. You see this, right? Okay, lay them down flat like this as well. I didn't go all the way through. See what that looks like? If some are thick like this, I just cut them in half. Okay, super easy. All right, so we've got cucumber. You need to do, you could do all this stuff in advance too if you want. Making these, have all these ready. What I would do is probably at a party, if you want to have fun cooking with your friends, then have all this garnish and prep ready, and then you guys can roll the things yourself, and then it gives your guests a feeling of accomplishment. So it's kind of nice. So we'll do the rest of the cucumbers as well. With the radish, I have a daikon radish here. You could use a red radish if you want, but I like these long, thin strips that I'm gonna make from this. So with this, the same as a cucumber, I'm gonna cut straight down like this, okay? And we're gonna make a julienne slice after. So julienne is when you take and you put everything flat like this, right? And so for you guys at home, you're working on your cuts as you get better and better. These, there's not that many, right, when it comes to vegetables, so you practice these and you get good at them soon, it makes cooking a lot easier. So I've laid all these flat like this, right? And then we're gonna just go ahead and cut down this lengthwise, like this. And then I've got this this is what we call the julienne strips. So these julienne strips of cucumber are really nice. Okay, like that, all done. Now, if you wanted to, you can season these a little with salt. It's gonna soften them up a little bit, but you don't have to. And then with carrot, now carrot, because it's a little bit more firm, sometimes I shred carrot too for kind of a differential in shape and color. So I just put it on a box grater like this and shake it. And then it's just gonna get this nice shredded carrot feel. Okay. And this is looking good. Okay. All right, I'm gonna clean up the rest of these and we'll be right back. Okay, guys, my shrimp has been sitting here long enough. It's been about 3 to 4 minutes. So what I wanna do is strain the water off and I'm gonna add ice water. Well, you can add ice right to this if you want, but I'm just gonna strain this out. So I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I have my shrimp here. They're cooled now and I wanna just peel them. They're a lot easier to peel when they've been cooked like this, especially fresh shrimp. They're so nice. So I'm gonna go ahead and just peel these like this, right? And it's always better if you actually chill them, you know, strain them and chill them. I like to chill the broth down itself because the broth is got a lot of flavor in it. Once we do that, we're gonna take the shrimp, lay them down, okay? And then we're gonna cut them in half lengthwise like this. When we flip this over, well, the reason we're doing that, one is just to give a smaller bite inside these hand side rolls, but it's also like, if you can see, some of these have a little bit of, there's a little bit of stuff in their digestive tract and you wanna get that out. So if you see that in the shrimp, in the poop trail, it's got some stuff in there, you wanna cut it out because that's gonna be, you know, bad flavor. So we wanna go ahead and peel all these and clean them up, and we'll be back in a second, okay? And we'll put these things together. Right before I do finish those shrimp, I'm gonna wanna go ahead and strain these noodles as well. And I like to rinse them in a little cold water, that way they're ready to go into this cold dish. So I'm gonna take these, strain these, and I'm gonna rinse them in a little cold water, and then we're gonna finish these shrimp, and we're gonna put these shrimp rolls together. Okay, guys, we've got everything cleaned up. I've got my rice papers out here. I've got a pan of warm water. This is not hot water. I haven't boiled it or anything. It's just warm. Whoops. Let me make sure I get these papers out. These things can crack easily. Cracked out. So you want to just make sure to be gentle with them. Okay. There's two sides. There's kind of a rougher side and there's a smoother side. I'll leave that smoother side for the outside. I just quickly dip these in water like this and I let it move over like that, and it's gonna like get soft quickly. Don't soak it for too long. And then you wanna put your lettuce here. You can use any type of lettuce that you particularly like. I like to go heavy with the lettuce, okay? I'm gonna put a little bit of noodles in there, not too much, just a little bit, okay? Like this. I'm gonna put some bean sprouts. Right? Stick everything right in the center. It's gonna fall to the outside, so you wanna stick it right in the center. That keeps it nice, right? A few, two or three cucumber pieces, right? Like this, and then I put some radish pieces like this, okay? And then I can take a little bit of my carrot. And then I wanna put herbs. I've got mint, and you can use cilantro if you like cilantro better than mint. But I like to put mint and I like to put Thai basil, okay? And then you want to wrap this up. By now, your rice paper has gotten a little bit softer. Now, I might have made a nice big fat one here, so you don't have to make them that fat, okay? You can do a little bit less in there. And then I want to put my shrimp here. So I lay the shrimp here, and I lay shrimp here like this, okay? And then I wrap the ends in like this, and I fold it over. By the time I roll it up, you see I get that beautiful shrimp on there like that. And that's ready to go. So You practice with these, have fun with the family and do it. Super simple. I've got a little Thai peanut dipping sauce that you can click up here and see how we make that. Or you can just dip it in some, you can have some fish sauce. The 3-2-1 sauce is always nice too, it's refreshing. It's three parts of water, two parts of vinegar, and three parts of water, two parts of sugar, one part of vinegar. And then you put fish sauce to flavor it. And then you can put chilies in there as well. We'll be making that pretty soon too, so you can try that if you don't like a thicker sauce like that. But that's it. Look how simple that is. These eat so nice, and you're just gonna dip that in your beautiful peanut sauce. Mmm, that was a mouthful. So good. The flavor of the peanuts with all of that, I just really love it. So if this is something you guys think you would like, or you've had it in restaurants, you can see how simple it is to do it at home. Make sure you try it. If you have any comments or questions, shoot them to me and I can answer them to you before you try it. And do this at home. I'll see you back in the kitchen soon. I'm Chef Dean Max.